Welcome everybody to the Monrovia City Council recap for Tuesday, October 17th. My name is Julie Bank, and with me is
Chris Loos, your favorite co-host.
Absolutely. You know, he's usually in the seat. Now I'm in the seat today. So thank you for letting me have that opportunity. And our other co-host is
Garrett Laporte.
And I am so thrilled to be with both of these folks, where we look at what's happening in the city over the past week. And before we do that, we want to make sure that
you know this thoroughly, that you can be a part of our team.
You could be here.
Where you could be in this seat, you could be in this seat, whatever you are most comfortable with, or maybe you could be behind
seat.
The scenes.
Maybe.
That one.
Yeah, you could take, you know, I'll give you mine, right? But just, we'd love for you to be here. The more perspectives that are sitting at this table, it represents our community better, and it allows you to hear how things were received from the city council meeting even better. So KGEM-TV@gmail.com is where you can go. Just shoot an email real quick. Would love to be a part, or can you let me know? We'll get back to you, and we will save a seat here for you. It's not a huge like requirement either. Like, it's, you're gonna spend maybe a couple hours a year. So KGEM-TV@gmail.com. Love to have you here.
Mm-hmm. And you get to hang out with a couple of really cool people and listen to a lot of different perspectives. So we're going to jump right in. Again, it was the meeting on October 17th, and the meeting was called to order at 7:34. All the council members were in attendance except for Gloria Crudgeton, who was excused. Mm-hmm. I hope she's doing well. Mm-hmm. It started off with the invocation, which was given by Rena Martinez, and she's from the Interfaith Council, and I think she represented Foothill Unity, is what I heard her say. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. And the Pledge of Allegiance was given by Councilmember Jimenez.
Yep.
So at 5:45, we started a fairly long conversation and proclamation about volunteerism. Mm-hmm. We specifically proclaimed October 28th, Make a Difference Day. That was read by Councilmember Jimenez, and he also gave a presentation because the CEO of the Volunteer Center was not able to be there. So he gave a presentation all about volunteerism, and there were some themes that he really focused on. So first of all, he encourages everybody to come out and volunteer at Make a Difference Day on October 28th. Mm-hmm. Have you guys been there before?
I missed it last year. I will be there this year.
Perfect. Yeah. Perfect. And have you ever been there?
I've seen mumblings of it around, and I know that the sort of bulk pickup kind of is the thing everyone talks about. It's like, I got all this stuff to get rid of. Yeah.
Well, it's an amazing day to see so many people come out and make a difference in our community and just do something as a group and do something to make Monrovia a better place. This year, there's going to be 20 groups participating, and there will be 15 different projects that they're going to be working on.
Wow.
And there is a theme. And the theme is humble and kind, mm-hmm. which I think is an amazing theme. And later on, Mayor Shevlin was talking a lot about being humble and kind and the importance of not only having that just be one day of being humble and kind, but always being humble and kind.
Mm-hmm. Every day.
Keep that.
So it was, I thought that was a really nice theme for them to choose this year and to also have every day as part of our life.
One of the things I love is seeing the 15, like the intention behind it, 15 projects. Like, when you got a lot of people, you can really do great work, mm-hmm. if you just concentrate that effort. So shout out to everybody involved who's put this together, so we can specifically help in spaces.
Yeah, I will encourage everybody, though this is my own thing, I'll encourage everybody to volunteer all the time rather mm-hmm. than just on one day, but coming out on one day starts it off right.
Yeah.
So that's pretty mm-hmm. cool. They also honor a few volunteers, and this year, instead of honoring individuals, they're honoring groups. So there are a couple of different groups that are going to be honored. We have the Baha'i Faith, mm-hmm. we have the Monrovia Canyon Park Volunteers, we have Upward Bound Study Center, and we have the Second Baptist Church of Monrovia. Mm-hmm. All of those folks that are part of those groups are going to be honored for their activities throughout the year, and we appreciate them so much. And I want to give a big shout out to the Monrovia Canyon Park volunteers. Those individuals are there 3 days a week, making our parks better, and they're really a bunch of cool dudes, so, and ladies too. But
absolutely,
just wanted to say thank you to all of those individuals who are that.
And shout to Miss Golar, who's on the City Council recap team, but her and a lot of her Baha'i family, they get out and do a lot of stuff. I met a few of them at the Marinol Garden doing work up there and getting that right, so mm-hmm. Yeah.
Awesome. So come out on October 28th for Make a Difference Day. Yes. Pre-sign up. If you didn't pre-sign up, then you just show up and they'll put you to work.
I'll be the one helping put you to work, by the way.
I believe the volunteering like scheduling, like you can register at like 7 a.m. and mm-hmm. then like you show up at like 8.
That's
and they'll,
right.
like you said, mobilize you.
Yep.
Yep.
And you get a t-shirt.
You do get a t-shirt.
Which is pretty cool. And they actually gave all the city council members a goodie bag. Mm-hmm. And in the goodie bag was a t-shirt.
Oh.
So that was pretty amazing. At 1840, we had the Pet of the Month from the Pasadena Humane Society. And all of you who know me know that's probably my favorite part of the agenda. They introduced us to senior pup Chester.
Chester!
Chester, who is 9 years old, and there was some conversation about what type of breed he was. They said he was a lab, but it ended up being he was just a good old brown dog. Mm-hmm. But he is waiting for a home. And that day they started Adopt-A-Boo promotion.
Right.
Which means if you're over 31 pounds, you're only $10. So it's a good time to adopt a pet and mm-hmm. go there and ask for Chester. Mm-hmm. Anybody yes. looking for a pet?
We just added another to the herd, so I'm gonna ease up.
All right.
Well, I'd like another dog. I'm just worried my cat will attack him. I have a cat that just
have to find
attacks
out.
Dogs.
Well, I will help you do an introduction. We could talk about that later.
Of course.
Go look for Chester at the Pasadena Humane Society. From there, we had the student report.
Yes.
And that was at 2246. Mm-hmm. And they spoke a lot about all of the activities during homecoming. Mm-hmm. They had Spirit Week, Spirit Day. They had the football game. They had a dance. My son is at Monrovia High School, mm-hmm. so he got the opportunity to experience all of that. We have lots of cool pictures from the dance. But it was a really spectacular week, and a lot of kids were having a lot of fun.
I was there that day. I was there on the Spirit Day, and they had the Spirit Rally, and it was a pink day. And
pink
I guess
day.
It's been like a huge tradition for several years now. Like, and they came back after like this rally, and they were all coming in. And what was so heartwarming is just the energy
yeah.
in the room, and you could tell. Like, of course, some kids are like, it's a day. I don't really have to do anything. But it's also like, no, they're really engaging with each other, and they're really feeling like, oh yeah, Monrovia High School, it's my home, homecoming. And it was cool. I was like, man, there's the little things about high school that you're like, that was sweet.
Oh,
that
was forever. Cool. Those are the forever things.
Yeah, 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 yeah.
And it was really nice that they took the opportunity to celebrate breast cancer awareness.
Yes.
That's the whole pink out. And I know that a lot of the kids participated, as well as the whole point of homecoming is that alumni come too. So I know at the football game there were a lot of alumni. So thank you, alumni, for continuing to support your Wildcats. At 2542, mm-hmm. they issued the consent calendar. Nothing was pulled, so the motion was made by Councilmember Spicer. It was seconded by Councilman Jimenez, and then all were in favor. And then they went to public input at 2635. There were two speakers.
Yes.
The first speaker was named Teresa, and she spoke about multiple apartment projects. And her particular concern was that there was a lack of Section 8 housing requirements in those projects. She was wondering why there were no additional hospitals as well. She felt if we're going to be bringing in more people and there's going to be more traffic, then there's possibly going to be more need for a hospital. So she was just concerned about the process of bringing in new housing units. If they are meant for individuals who are unhoused, what are we doing to make sure that they get housed? So she just had a lot to say about that.
I like I like the shout about the hospitals because, like, growing up, I was right by Santa Teresita Hospital. So it was seeing that become now a medical center for certain services. It was like, oh, man, like, you know, we saw during the pandemic, it was...
Lots of need, unfortunately.
Yeah, I like that shout.
The next public input was on the phone, and that was Thomas and his wife. Unfortunately, I didn't capture his wife's name, but they spoke about the recent League of Cities event, and they were specifically concerned about the new election systems that the cities are going to. They thought that there's a chance that they could be rigged, and they were wondering why people were not considering going back to the hand-counted options. So we know that that issue is a controversial issue, and that was their concern.
He quoted Shasta County or Shasta City as like it's a place in California that has gone back to just traditional, like it's just right. It's just handwritten ballots. Interestingly, there was no punchline to that thesis. He just kind of said it, and I'm sure, in good faith, I'm sure there was a point there. But I think the thing hearing this was interesting, and I'm very happy and glad for anyone to just get civic engagement going, and you know, get on the phone. Go to the meeting, speak your voice. But I am interested in the further dialogue of like, okay, is it actually tangibly better? Because I don't feel like that was ever communicated. He was like, why are you getting rid of them and doing the electronic ones? And I feel like the burden of proof is because they're better. But I think that the comment is made to imply they're not better. And so I think, obviously, these topics, the public input, is not things that the council can discuss at that time.
Yeah. Right.
But
speaking of following up, and I'm not going to follow up on that one, there was also discussion on the first speaker.
The
Section 8 stuff. And
yes.
Mayor Shevlin did ask the city attorney to find out more information about mm-hmm. the rules regarding public housing.
Yeah, and
so I think we'll have further dialogue about that, probably on an agenda at some point.
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah.
I'd like to see more public comment.
Same.
Just me, like, these Facebook groups get wild, so I'd right. love to see it happen mm-hmm. like in real time, at a real space where something real can happen.
Face to face.
Yeah, like, and with the people, though, that can
instead
really
of behind
make
a computer.
Something happen. Like, council doesn't have time to be in our
right.
20-plus Facebook groups that we have in Monrovia. So to get there, if you really want to see it happen,
right.
I'd love to see it.
All right, at 3340, there was a public hearing. And I thought it was a pretty cool public hearing because there was a presentation given on address 423 East Foothill. They were requesting to make their property a historic landmark. They did a presentation on that property. And what's different about that property from other properties is that it was a multifamily residential unit rather than an individual unit. There were no public comments. Council Member Spicer motioned. Council Member Dr. Kelly seconded it, and all were in favor. But, you know, looking at our amazing historic homes that we have in Monrovia is just part of, I think, what makes us special. I was watching
exactly.
a TV show the other day, and I was like, I think I recognize that house.
Yeah.
And it was just really nice to have more historic homes here.
I love it.
Can I point out an irony?
Sure.
Of the public comment prior of the like, hey, this new big building that's going behind the metro station, right? That's the one they were talking about, right? I think, because you said it was up DeWardy Road.
They didn't specifically say, but.
Okay, then maybe I'm wrong on that. But whatever this DeWardy Road property, it's like, it's all going to be nicer apartments that we know is not going to affordable housing or like it's not part of the Section 8. And then we move to the historical, like, oh, look at when housing was so accommodating for multifamilies. Isn't that great? Part of our history? And I go, huh. Interesting.
Times change. Mm-hmm. Times change and move on, but we're still dealing with the same issues, right?
Yeah.
Okay, at 39:26, we had the city manager directive reports. Mm-hmm. And Dylan Feek spoke about the continued work on Peck Road, on the repairs on Peck Road. He said that at the next meeting, there's going to be a contract and a design put on the agenda. So watch the next meeting if you want more information on that, mm-hmm. and that the work is going to be done next year.
Right.
The next thing he spoke about was the auto repair shop ordinance issues. And he said they're continuing to work on that. And then the third thing was sharing, they're going to start community engagement regarding the Clean Power Alliance, and they're starting to do some presentations to the senior community at senior events like the Gadabouts and some of the other senior. They're going to be doing presentations there.
Gotcha.
Love it.
At 42:40, we started our council reports. And let me tell you, these council reports were, we do so much in Monrovia. It is amazing. And it's amazing how many activities the council themselves are going to as well. So it started off with Councilmember Jimenez, where he said that he participated in Read Across America, and he went to Plymouth Elementary School. I wanted to do it this year, but it didn't fit my schedule, but it's gonna be definitely on my agenda to read next year. You just sign up with Monrovia Reads, and they'll just let you know, and they'll put you to a school, and you get to pick a book, and you get to read to kids.
Calm down.
And actually, he picked two books. He picked Samson the Hot Tub Bear by Wendy Takuha. I think I pronounced that. I hope I pronounced that right. And that was, you know, to teach some history about Monrovia. He said that the kids had great questions. And then he also read Carmen Learns English.
Yes.
And he said for him that was a personal book because when he came and went to school, he needed some assistance to learn English. Yeah. So both of those were great. He also participated in the Monrovia Unified and Latino Heritage Society Arts Show and specifically pointed out the Latin dancing that occurred and how much he liked that. He went to the community meeting about the new park that's going to be by Chick-fil-A. I happened to be at that meeting as well, right? We were both there. And the community reminded us that the community can have input on all of the parks, and you should come to these meetings or go to the community center and give your input, right?
Yeah, it was great. I love that. It was just, you had an opportunity to draw if something that
that's
you
right.
like
you went
or
with
write
your son,
it in.
And
yeah.
he was
it was great.
I think he's going to be an architect.
Yeah, it was cool.
They still need to name the park, right?
Yeah, they're still. I think they've closed the naming, and now they're just going to the selection committee. Gotcha. I am a community services commissioner, and we get to have final, I think not final say, but we get to be part of that selection process, so that's going to be exciting. He also talked about new native landscaping that is happening at Monrovia High School. And later on, Mayor Shevlin talks about how the city of Monrovia participated and had given trees to that as well.
They took out trees. They took out old stuff. I remember it was like, I think after 2021 or something, they were taking stuff out. And now, every time I have to walk in, it's just like there's so much work going on. It's a huge project. Yeah. It's a really impressive project.
Last Saturday, he attended the Fall Festival, and I was there too at the Empower booth, Monrovia Parks Recreation Wilderness Foundation booth. Mm-hmm. And it was just so nice to see so many families come out and just celebrate the fall and enjoy. And he was talking about what a beautiful day it was. And at the same day was the fire and rescue event at Firehouse. I don't know if it was at 101 and 102 or just the main firehouse, but I guess they said that they had the most attended participation this year than ever. Wow. So it was a great day. You go to the Fall Festival and then walk right over to the firehouse and have fun and activities.
Well, there was a weekly update that went out about that.
Yeah. So then there was, the next report was from council member Dr. Kelly, and she talked about the Art in the Park with MAFA the week before, and specifically talked about how the chalk art was cool.
So cool.
It's amazing, right?
Oh,
and so she good. Was worried about it like happening and then being washed away. And I think Dylan said, no, it's going to be there for a while, and it's probably still there if you want to go see it.
Yeah.
So. That was pretty neat.
Go see it.
Yeah.
Go see it.
It's pretty spectacular how you can do all that with
And truck. I love that they leave the truck there for the kids to paint on.
Yeah.
Because that's just fun.
I learned something new. It's the same truck that was last year. And what they do is they power wash it.
Okay.
And then they bring the same truck back and they get to wash it. So it's pretty neat. Dr. Kelly also gave a shout out to the community services staff, realizing when she went to the park event how much work they put behind. So go team there.
Absolutely.
She gave an update that the state of the schools address was going to happen on the 18th, which was actually yesterday.
And is streaming now on the KGEM YouTube channel.
That's right.
So you can check it out.
And I'm assuming you're going to talk about it at the next school board.
We didn't even need to talk about it.
It's right on there.
Okay. Yeah, it's all
perfect.
There.
Pretty much there, yeah.
She then went into the League of California Cities and Expo event that all of the city council members went to. And for her, she really appreciated the focus on homelessness and mental health. And she specifically called out SB 43, which is a new piece of legislation that was signed into law, making it easier to help people with conservatorships. You look like you want to say something.
No, I'm just thinking. It's so funny. We had the conversation today about it. It's like, you know, what's our thoughts about it? And I was like, oh, that's right. They did talk about it at the meeting. They all kind of went there.
Yes.
And they were all talking about how, like, a lot of these cities, and Dr. Kelly said it, and I know you'll probably get to it, but Mayor Shevlin said it. It's like all these cities are all in this now roundhouse conversation on homelessness and its...
And mental health.
And how they are tied and they are completely connected.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. They did all talk about that, which is really great that we're all talking about it because it's an important topic that impacts everybody. Yeah. You go on to the next report, which was Councilmember Spicer's report. He told everybody that there was a job fair that's going to be held, or actually it was held yesterday. It was the 18th, right? At the Monrovia Adult School. And I hope there was a whole lot of people that were able to learn more about jobs and maybe even find a job.
The adult school does a phenomenal job also of landing jobs. So a lot of their students actually get placed. It was a great percentage. I don't want to say it because I'll probably get it wrong, but it was a very high percentage after you get there, you're getting employed.
So. Yeah, they said there were about 100 people that showed up. And
That's great.
And not only did they get a job, but if they had a certain amount of signups or interviews, they also got, there was a food truck and also gave them some good food.
Oh, nice.
So they got job work and also food. He also talked about the League of Cities event, and for him, he highlighted the keynote speaker, and he said the keynote speaker was focused on conflict and conversation. And he shared that it was such an important message for all of us to know about and to think about, is that we can have dialogue, we can have discourse, we can have conflict, but we need to learn how to talk about it.
Yeah.
And we need to learn, and that's kind of what this this program is about, right?
Yeah.
Is about talking about different issues, but talking about it in a way where we're respectful and we're kind and all of that.
Absolutely.
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah.
So then we went into Mayor Shevlin's report, and she had a lot to talk about. She also talked about the League of Cities event that she reminded us it was held on September 20th to the 22nd. There were about 2,000 city officials there. She wanted us to know about a presentation that she went to that reminded her that sometimes programs are awesome, but we have to always think about the unintended consequences of the programs. And she gave an example of that. So just kind of something to think about. We all want something to happen, but we don't always realize, you know, the cost involved.
Or
we don't realize the sacrifice. You're giving up something else. She also talked about the Care Solace program, which connects people with services. And she had asked Dylan to look into it for the city.
Mm-hmm.
She said the school district does that. Spoke about the upcoming Spooktacular. Everybody should come out on Halloween.
Please come out.
Please come out. Wear your best costume. There's contests for you and your pet and for your family. She highlighted that she's going to be highlighted in the Business Life magazine as a woman of distinction.
Yep.
So congratulations,
congrats,
Mayor Shevlin. She was also elected by the San Gabriel Valley Sector Blue Ribbon Committee on Homelessness Executive Committee. Looking forward to hearing more about that.
Yes.
She read a certificate to Chuck Pollard for his 90th birthday. Happy birthday, Chuck.
Yeah, 90. That's awesome.
She spoke about a workshop that's coming up on Thursday, November 2nd at 6 p.m. where Alice Atkins, our city clerk, is going to be holding a workshop on what it takes to run for office. It's going to be at the Monroe Room at the library. And she wanted us to know that November 13th through December 8th is the nomination period. Yep. So if any of you out there are interested in running for office, go to this workshop, learn more, and then file.
And if you can't make it and you want to do something right now, go to the KGEM YouTube channel because we did a show on how to run for office. Mm-hmm. You're going to get a lot of great information. It is going to direct you right to Alice because Alice is the one you're going to want to talk to. Yeah. But you'll get a great scope of what it's going to take for you to run. So
perfect. That's available. Perfect. So at 1 hour 9:32, they did have one directive. She did have one directive of that was given to the staff. So Mayor Shevlin had asked Dylan to start getting information out on some of the ballot initiatives that are going to happen in this election period. And she specifically highlighted the sales tax initiative and the homeless mental health initiatives that are happening. So hopefully we'll begin to hear more about and become educated about those ballots so that we can know what we're voting for. It's important to be aware of that, not just check a box. There were no administrative reports or public input on administrative reports. Mayor Shevlin ended the meeting asking everybody to keep your thoughts, your positive thoughts, for Marcia Gracia's family. So everybody out there, please have collective good thoughts. And then the meeting closed on at 8:45. I think, as we know, the next meeting is scheduled for, next Tuesday?
Yeah. No, it's after Halloween.
It's after Halloween.
They're not. That's why she talked about Spooktacular. She was like, hey, we're not going to meet until after Halloween. So I believe it's like that first week of November.
Okay. Well, you can go on the city website to find out more about the next meeting. And they're always encouraging you to come live or watch it on at KGEM. Yep. And we encourage everybody to be involved. Last minute thoughts.
Get out and volunteer for Make a Difference Day.
Yes.
Two hands combined with all the other hands that are going to be there can make some amazing things happen here in town. So do that.
It'll be fun. It'll be really fun. Go volunteer, please.
And I'll say they have activities for not only you, but for your children as well. So make it a family event.
Yeah.
Thank you, everybody, for listening, and we'll see you next time.